Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. Today I'm going to show you how to cut your video to the beat of the music. Now, there's not one right way, and that's one of the beautiful things about video editing, is there's so many different approaches depending on what works best for you as an editor. So the first method, of course, is the manual way, and I actually made a video on how to do this where you press the M key to create markers in your timeline that match the beat. But not all of us are musicians or know when the exact beat is, so this is kind of imperfect, and it also takes a long time depending on how long the music track is. And the second way is Acusonus's BeatMarker, which is completely free. It's a free panel, and you can basically import your audio and it will create the amount of beats based on the amount of edits that you want. But this isn't exactly perfect because it won't necessarily put all of the beats along the entire track. And there's a paid for plugin called BeatEdit by Mama World. It has a lot more capability. So I'm gonna show you the BeatMarker and the BeatEdit so you can decide which will work best for you. But one thing I just wanna say is that these are just starting points, right? Because let's say you're editing a music video or a commercial, you don't want necessarily a video edit at each marker because that's kind of a boring edit. You're going to play around with it, right? But the benefit of having the markers is that you can, you know, roll an edit out to last for four beats. And because all the beats are there, you'll know exactly where to edit. All right, so enough talking about it. I want to show you how it works. But before we jump in, I want to thank Artlist for sponsoring today's video. They provided the music for this video, as well as Artgrid provided the video clips. So if you're interested in getting amazing royalty-free music and sound effects, and amazing footage from Artgrid, you can check out my links below. And if you sign up with my link, you will get an extra 2 months free. So without further ado, the time codes are just down below, and let's go ahead and jump on in. So here's the final edit here in the timeline. And you can see that there's a bunch of markers. As I zoom in on the bottom here, these are single beats. And up on the top here on the sequence, these are half beats that I made because you will see visually in the edit in the beginning, it's every two beats. And then these clips here, these are every three beats. And then when it gets super fast here to the rhythm of the music, it depends on your music, I did every half beat. And I'm not a musician, so I wouldn't have been able to guess how to do that. And that's why a beat edit was super helpful. BeatMarker can do the beats, but BeatEdit would allow me to cut the beats in half, which is what I needed. So let me play just from here so you can kind of see the rhythm changes from the two beats to the three beats to every half beat here. So you saw that it was just super fast, right? It was like, I wouldn't have been able to get that at the right half beat mathematically without the help of the beat edit. So let's go ahead and start from scratch here. So I got this footage from Artgrid, but you may be getting footage from a director or a cinematographer. This footage here is called Flamenco and it's from Azul Roto, this group, the traveling couple that shoots this amazing footage here that I chose. And I wanted to get music that matched flamenco style of dancing. So I went on to Artlist and I just searched for flamenco. It was the first track that came up. I just played this one and I was like, this is it. So that's it. And I just went over here to click download and I downloaded the WAV file just like that. And it downloads to your computer. And then you can save it into your project file, which I recommend for organization, so that way nothing gets offline in the future. And you can import it here into your project panel, which is what I did. And I also have all of the footage from Artgrid already imported. Let's show you how to use the BeatMarker first. If you are on a budget and you can't afford BeatEdit, which right now is priced at $99 normally, but sometimes they do have sales, so keep an eye out during Black Friday. So let's show you how to start with the free method with BeatMarker. So after you install it, go up to Window, Extensions, BeatMarker. And this will allow you to import your audio. You can also select from project files as well. So I'm going to import the Flamenco Youth and it will analyze my audio. Now you'll see here that you can change the number of edits. Right now, just 26, but that only places markers towards the end of the track. What if you want the markers to be all along? Well, if you want all of the markers in the timeline for every single beat, you can change this to the maximum, which is 134. And now you'll see that there's a blue line at every single beat, and you'll hear a little hoof clapping at every single blue marker, and it's super fast. And I would not have been able to know that that is the beat, because flamenco is very complex music. And I think that this is a great example of how you can use BeatMarker, this free tool, to help you identify the beats without being a musician, right? So let's just play this. So you can see it's pretty fast, right? Now, before you hit create markers, you want to close this final edit that we have open, because it'll start to overlay all of the markers on here. And that just happened to me, which I recommend not doing because it's a huge pain in the butt, because you have to like hit undo like a bunch of times and it's not cool. So I'm going to close the final edit. So I'm going to go back to my project. I'm going to right click and I'm going to duplicate this final edit, and I'll just call this demo. Open this up, clear all markers, and I'm going to delete the footage, right? Because we don't need that. And the flamenco music track is here, but let's also clear the markers here. Markers, clear all markers. There we go. So now we have the music track here inside of the sequence, and let's go back to BeatMarker and we can create markers. And it starts to randomly place all of the markers to the beat inside of this music track, inside of the timeline. You can see as we zoom in that there are markers for every single beat here. Now, if we wanted to, we could go to our footage and we could go into the thumbnail icon view. And this is where we can kind of see visually everything that's happening in all of the clips. And what I actually recommend doing is going through and kind of moving the clips around where you want them to be in the order that you lay them in the timeline. So you can move these clips around just by clicking and moving them. And then what you can do is you can go through and you can identify in and out points. So if you want the start of this clip to be the beginning, you don't have to press I for endpoint, but you can go to the part where you want it to end and press O for out points. So in and out points. And you can do this for every single clip. So you can press I and then O for in. And on all these clips, you can go through and do that quickly and reorder them until it looks right. So now what we can do is automate all these clips to the sequence. You can select the first one and then press shift and select the last clip. And then rather than dragging and dropping this into the timeline, you can click on this little icon, automate to sequence, and you can use it in selection order. So the clips, the way that we selected it, and at the unnumbered markers, okay? And it's okay to overwrite the edit because there's nothing inside of it. And you can have ignore audio because it's not relevant because we're going by the markers, and then hit okay. Voila, you can see it's at every single beat. Now, there's not enough footage for the entire clip, and that's okay, because what you can do is you can then go through and be like, okay, I don't want these clips to be just one beat. I want to extend it out. So you can go through and decide how long you want these clips to be. And it's kind of a manual process. You'd have to go through and manually move all of these over. And a good way of doing this is by selecting the lock track. And then you can press A to go to the track select forward. And you can shift all these clips over. Then press V to go back to the selection tool. And you can select these clips and move them back into place. So this is BeatMarker. There are some limitations. There's only the option to have a number of edits. You can't do half beats. You can't have markers in the timeline for every two beats. This is where BeatEdit comes in handy. So I'm going to go up to Window Extensions, BeatEdit by Mama World. And what I'm going to do is get rid of all the markers that we just made from BeatMarker before we use BeatEdit. So I'm going to go over here and hit Undo to undo all of those markers. And then I'm going to delete all of the clips here. and back to BeatEdit. So here, to load in the music, you just hit load music. And it'll tell you, please select exactly one audio file in the active sequence. So I can unlock this and select the audio file first, then load the music. And here we have the beats. So you could hit this icon here, create markers, to have single beats inside of the timeline. Or what you can do is you can say, oh, I want it every two beats. So you can go here, every two beats, and hit select. And now when we play it back, then you can select create markers, and it'll place the markers in the timeline every two beats. If you want to have the footage automate to sequence, once this is done, I can move the playhead to the beginning first and then go to the footage and select automate to sequence. Okay. And it automatically places it starting at this first marker here. Now you'll notice that some of it doesn't line up perfectly, and that's because, for example, our in and out points was too short on this clip, but I can roll this out. So remember, I set in and out points, the out point was a little bit too short for the length of those two beats. And same with this one that I rolled out. This first shot here, as we can pull this out, it'll, you know, start at the beginning. So it's a much better pace, right? So this is a great starting point to then move the clips around. If you just wanted to use BeatEdit to have every two beats first, but then you want to select another group of footage to be every half beat. So what we can do is we can actually clear the markers, delete the markers that we have here. And this is a much easier process than in BeatMarker. And we can redo them in the half beats. So this is how we do it. So we go into every one beats again, and now I'm going to divide it by two. So it's every half beat. And now I'm going to place these markers into the sequence so I can easily automate a new group in this half beat. Select this icon, create markers. I'm just going to take a few moments to generate the markers inside the timeline. By the way, underneath beat info and beat edit, it'll show you how many beats it generated in the entire timeline. So 135 half beats is what was just placed in the timeline. So now that they're here, what we can do is we can go to this beat exactly where this one ended, right here. So now we're going to go back into our footage folder and select all the shots that we want to line up at every half beat. So to do that, you can select your first clip and then press shift down to the last clip that you want to import into the timeline. Again, automate to sequence at unnumbered markers, hit OK, and bam. Now we have a bunch at the half beats. So the reason why I'm showing you this is that first we did it by every two beats, right? And now it's half beats depending on the rhythm. And of course, then you can go in and, you know, delete a section of it and, you know, manually put in some new clips. But you get the idea here, right? It's like you can go through and say, oh, here I want to place a bunch of clips at one beat or every three beats. And it's just a nice way of approaching it. In BeatEdit, you can also add markers to the clip itself. So you can select the clip, then go to BeatEdit. Let's say that on this clip, we want to add one beat every one beat. Subdivide beats off. There we go. We want to place these beats as reference on the actual audio clip, not on the sequence. So this is where we'll change it to clip markers. Okay, clip markers, and then create markers. So now inside of our clip here, you can start to see some markers being generated. It just added a bunch of single beats on the actual clip. So that way you can see above our half beats on the sequence and single beats below. So this is useful if you want to, for example, make one clip a single beat or more, or two beats. You can drag this out and then you can select all of these clips here and move it over, for example. this may not be exactly where I would do it, but I'm just showing you that this is how you would edit this quickly. Another tip, you can press N on your keyboard to create the rolling edit tool. And let's say you want to move this edit point here at this beat marker, you can select the edit point and move it over. And now this clip is two beats. So you can use the clip markers and the sequence markers as a guide. So that way, when you're making your edits and your rhythm, you're making sure that it's on beat throughout your entire edit and you're not kind of going in blind guessing where all of the edits are. So that's how I was able to go through and build my final edit, which I'll pull up again, which you can see has this different rhythm to it throughout. And so that's how you can use BeatEdit or BeatMarker to edit to the beat and help guide your edit. So overall, you can use these beat markers to help get you started in your edit, but you may need to move clips around, hold out and edit for a few more beats. It all depends on your subjective point of view. You may need to swap, you know, videos because you're building a story, or the director says, oh, I want this shot to go here. It's a process with editing. It's not just automate all of these video clips to the sequence and you're done. There's a lot more that goes into an edit. And sometimes I'll spend a couple hours just moving clips around until I feel like it fits right. And, you know, if you have a better workflow, let me know what you use. Let me know what you think about BeatEdit or BeatMarker. If you're going to use that, just leave a comment below. And I just want to give another thanks to Artlist for sponsoring today's video. Don't forget, when you sign up with my link, you can get an extra 2 months free. And all of their music is YouTube friendly, social media friendly, commercial, personal. You don't have to worry about copyright strikes or anything like that. So I highly encourage you to check out their music and sound effects with my link below. And that's all for today's video. And as always, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye.